2018 has seen tremendous successes in every sector under the coalition government. Notwithstanding the challenges, Guyanese have benefited extensively from policies implemented by the administration. On this week's In-Depth, we review some of the key highlights in the social sector for 2018 and take a brief look into the prospects of 2019.
Dogs again, and no mailbox.
Don't let this happen to you.
I'm so happy that I get this mailbox. Now I get in all my mails. You know how much times GPL come and disconnect me life because I can't get my bill?
I will notice. Anyways, girl, the post office encouraging all residents to install a mailbox so they can improve their service to us.
Get your mailbox today and help the Guyana Post Office to serve you better.
What was considered to be the biggest highlight of 2018 was the passage of the largest budget ever in the history of Guyana. Minister of Finance Winston Jordan presented to the National Assembly a whopping $300 billion National Financial Plan on November 26, 2018, which after debate and consideration was given the green light by the House. Within this budget was prospect for economic growth in every productive sector, including the agriculture, fishing and forestry industries, which were forecast to grow by 3.9%. Sugar production was expected to increase by 15.6%, while rice was expected to grow steadily by 2.7% in 2019. Overall, the balance of payment is expected to improve substantially to a surplus of US $15 million. The capital account is anticipated to grow robustly to a surplus of US $376.2 million, with the current account reflecting a lower deficit of US $361.2 million.
On the basis of these principles, Budget 2019 has been crafted under the theme Transforming the Economy, Empowering People, Building Sustainable Communities for the Good Life. It signifies a strategic shift in the trajectory of our development as we seek to responsibly use the resources from petroleum to shape our future through investing for growth and creating new industries and jobs. Budget 2019 prioritizes institutional strengthening across sectors, including strengthening public investment management, expanding opportunities for businesses to grow and flourish, and supporting government's green economy initiatives while aiming to support the development of the non-oil sector.
Minister Jordan credits the improvement of the current account to a lower merchandise trade deficit of US $256.4 million. As total export earnings are projected to increase amid higher commodity prices and increased production.
The Ministry of Education saw remarkable progress in 2018. A major highlight was a meeting between President David Granger and members of the Ghana Teachers Union to resolve issues of salary increases.
At the meeting, a new salary offer was extended to the GTU, which would see teachers being paid retroactive salary increases, beginning with 10% for 2016. And incremental increases of 8% for 2017 and 2018 respectively. A sum of $350 million was offered for a debunching for the period 2011 to 2018. Prior to that meeting, headed by President Mark Light, the GTU had organized a countrywide strike action affecting a few schools. The GTU had proposed an across-the-board increase in salary of 40% for 2016, 45% in 2017, 50% in 2018, 50% in 2019, and 50% in 2020 be granted to all categories of teachers, teacher educators for the years 2016 to 2020. Minister of Education, Dr. Nicolette Henry.
I have had the opportunity to be at the negotiating table with the union, and so I come today to speak to what that process was and where we are currently. After three meetings in August, I can say that we were able to have, you know, agreement on quite a few areas. There are eight recommendations that were made by the union. And by the time we would have concluded the three meetings, we have had agreement in some sort, whether partially or fully, in seven of the eight areas. And so that is something that you must note. And while it may be non-financial to the union, I want to say it is financial to the government. It comes with a cost for all the things that we sat there and we agreed upon in principle.
Another major accomplishment was the overwhelming performance of students at the National Grade 6 and Caribbean Secondary Certificate examinations. The results of the NGSA released in June 2018 revealed that it was the first time students were able to achieve 60% passes in English. Also, an historic 529 was scored by top-performing student Nalia Rahman of Westfield Prep. It was said to be a perfect score.
But we recognized that we have to invest in our people. And so that requires us recruiting additional supporting staff, developing and strengthening the existing programs to result in the kind of results that you see today. And it's not only specific to English. Last year, as you are aware, we did the intervention, which was intended to improve results.
The Ministry of Education has been allocated the largest budget for 2019. Some $52 billion has been pumped into the sector, all with the aim of providing Guyana's children with the best quality education.
More training, scholarships, hefty increases to minimum wages and salaries were some of the major highlights for the year 2018.
Close to 1,500 persons in 2018 received government-funded training or scholarships geared at building a robust public service. Minister of Public Service Rupert Rupnarine said that training is the only way to adequately equip Guyanese for the future. Master's degree in petroleum data management, petroleum exploration, oil and gas technology, software engineering, and cybersecurity, among others, were some areas of focus. Additionally, over 100 young people also graduated from the Bertram Collins College between 2017 and 2018. Graduates from the college pledged to bring professionalism to the public service.
What they should expect from me and my colleagues is efficiency. They should expect us to give the best service possible that Guyana has to offer. We are a new breed of public servants, and we are here to serve the people to our best ability, and that is what they can expect from us.
Minister Rupnarine had said the mission of the college is to ensure those entering the public service are adequately equipped.
It is towards this goal that the lion's share of this year's allocation to my ministry goes towards training and academic scholarships. $1.5 billion, representing a 50% increase over last year's expenditure of $1.08 billion.
Young people across Guyana in 2018 were offered numerous opportunities geared towards their empowerment. Millions of dollars were granted to youths to become entrepreneurs or develop their communities through the various initiatives.
Through funding from the Business Summit, a group of young men set out to take Guyana by storm by producing prosthetic limbs via 3D printing at an affordable cost.
We're very much grateful for the opportunity afforded to us today. I believe this summit was a great initiative, and directly it gave me a lot of drive to continue in the field of entrepreneurship and business.
Guyana is also more united. While the country has a far way to go, significant strides were made to bring Guyanese together. Numerous outreaches were carried out countrywide aimed at forging cohesion.
For me, it's good because we never had it before. And now that it's come to the Perica facade, it's a good thing. It helps persons to come together and help them to cooperate with each other, learn to live in love and unity.
For sports, the sum of $320 million in contracts were signed for the construction of two state-of-the-art synthetic tracks, one in New Amsterdam Region 6 and the other in Linden Region 10.
And I know we have so many of Usain Bolt here in Guyana, but we can only unearth them if we provide the necessary facility to the different areas in Guyana so that we can find those athletes.
The Ministry of Foreign Affairs ended 2018 on a high note when the United Nations Secretary General Antonio Guterres announced that he would be sending Guyana's long-standing border controversy for settlement to the International Court of Justice.
Guyana's border controversy with Venezuela sent before the International Court of Justice, ICJ, for resolution. The strengthening of diplomatic ties with China through the Belt and Road Initiative and Guyana's celebration of 50 years of diplomatic relations with Brazil are among some of the major achievements in foreign affairs for 2018.
Not 3 weeks ago, the Brazilian military undertook and completed an exercise of drilling wells to deliver potable water to 8 indigenous communities in the Rupununi.
Guyana's presence on the international stage increased in 2018 with the attendance and representation at several high-level meetings, including the 73rd United Nations General Assembly meeting, ACP Council of Ministers meeting, CARICOM Heads of Government meeting, CELAC EU Forum, ACP EU Joint Parliamentary Assembly, and the 8th Summit of the Americas, to name a few. In 2018, Ambassador Rudolph Michael Tenpao was elected by acclamation as a Vice President of the 73rd UN General Assembly. Later that month, Guyanese Dr. Christopher Arif Bolkan was also elected to serve on the United Nations Human Rights Committee for a term of 4 years, from 2019 to 2022. In 2018, the Ministry of Foreign Affairs also reported that rice exports to Cuba quadrupled, 70,000 tons, four times more than was exported at the end of 2017.
New arrival terminals at the Chedijangan International Airport and $827 million in roads commissioned for Madia are among the Ministry of Public Infrastructure's major achievements for 2018.
On September 22, 2018, the new arrivals terminal at Guyana's National Airport became fully functional, a major milestone in the airport's infrastructural development.
I am so impressed. You know, we stepped up. And this is so, so good. Yeah, I just don't know what to say.
It shows that Guyana isn't limited by what outside think, by the label developing country. It shows that there's a richness in the country, and clearly as you walk in, you see it, it hits you. So awesome job, Guyana.
In Madia, Minister of Public Infrastructure David Patterson hailed as a milestone the commissioning of the $827 million internal roads. Residents, in the meantime, said they were beyond happy with the progress of their community.
This here is like 200% better than what we had before. So, and not only that, the longevity, the long-lasting effects of this road, because it's 8 inches concrete, steel, and quartz stone. There was an attempt several years ago to do double asphalt, but I don't know if it was a single asphalt, but that road disappeared in, like, quickly. You would say 2 minutes, 5 seconds, but not actually 2 minutes, 5 seconds. And so this is great. The benefits would be accumulated. The benefits have already begun, and that people can expose their wares, their clothing, and so on, and not have them damaged.
There has been road improvement in all regions across the country, with the Linden to Lethem Road benefiting through a UK SIF grant. The grant also catered for review studies and construction of the Linden to Mabura Road and the Kurpukari Bridge.
2018 was an eventful year for the health sector. Capital projects were completed across the country, while a series of capacity training were held for staff.
The ministry ensured that the provision of land and water transportation to narrow the gaps in health services was fulfilled. Also, several structures were refurbished and upgraded, while others were extended to provide better services. Building staff complement was also a priority in the past year. 19 doctors returned to Guyana after being trained in Cuba, while 251 nurses were added to the Corps of Healthcare Workers from the Georgetown School of Nursing. The ministry worked to improve services in outlying areas, especially at primary healthcare facilities. This was essentially done so as to ensure health services are more accessible to those in need.
This is part of our vision, a part of our objective, to ensure that we bring health services to our people and we ease their burden and the cost which they incur of having to extend monies for these services.
For this ministry to have won this award, it said that the entity may have had an outstanding contribution to tobacco control as a crucial measure to rolling back NCDs. I've been in this country for about four and a half years. There was a time I went to a meeting in Trinidad, and all they said was, NCDs, Guyana is third from the bottom. At one meeting, I was told, well, Guyana is now second from the bottom. Ladies and gentlemen, Your Excellency, Acting Prime Minister, recently I was at a meeting in the Bahamas. and I was blown away. They talk about Guyana and says, Guyana is leading the way. They talk about Guyana, they said, Guyana is making strides.
The Ministry of Communities, headed by Minister Ronald Bulkan, continues to break barriers at every level. The year 2018 has been one of great successes.
One of the many positives for 2018 was the successful holding of the second consecutive local government election under the coalition government. Minister of Communities Ronald Bulkan has always expressed that the constitution provides for the involvement of people in the managing of their communities and developing the areas in which they live. Therefore, the LGE was executed with pride.
The holding of local government elections in 2018, the first time, I repeat, Mr. Speaker, the first time consecutive elections were held in our post-independence history, as lawfully due, removes any uncertainty about the primacy of local democracy and reinforces our commitment to democratic renewal at the local level.
Citizens from across the country had the opportunity to cast their ballot at last year's LGE.
You have to vote for the local government election in order to get things done in the correct manner. Because all the time we didn't know about local government election, but it's worth it. And I advise the young people to come out and vote.
I'm happy that the local government election is done, and I believe that I know the people that are in right now, they're going to work together because we are Bartishan. We believe in working together in one and in harmony. And I know that whoever win, going to do the same to continue the progress that is happening in Bartica here.
The government continued the road to reviving local democracy, and in August of 2018, the Region 8 community of Mahdia joined Bartica, Lethem and Mabaruma as one of the newest townships under the coalition government. The township status of Mahdia came in time for its first-time participation in the 2018 LGE. Mahdia's first mayor, David Adams, was sworn in by Prime Minister Moses Nagamutu.
The work has now begun. There's lots of work to be done. We are new, we are at the infant stage, and so therefore I look forward with optimism to doing an excellent job for the township of Mahdia over the next 12 months.
What are some of your plans over the next 12 months?
Well, we have to look firstly at infrastructure. There's a lot of work to be done in the area of infrastructure and infrastructure development. There have been lots of work done by the government already in the areas of roads and electricity and so on. But there are other works, bridges and so on, that we need to get going.
The Ministry of Communities has been allotted a total of $8.321 billion for 2019. Of that, Minister Bulkan said over $1 billion has been set aside as fiscal transfers to support the operations and community works of the local democratic organs, LDOs. Also, the government has agreed to invest $320 million to conduct mass property valuations over an 18-month period between October 2018 and the first quarter of 2020.
Meanwhile, Minister within the Ministry of Communities, Valerie Adams Yearwood, said the authority achieved many of its goals in 2018 and looks forward to reaching more targets in the new year.
As of October 31, 2018, several new Central Housing and Planning Authority schemes underwent major works. These include Lust and Russ, Zealot Phase 3, Rect Dorsey, and Zeeburg in Region 3, Sections B and D Nomprel, East Coast Demerara, La Penitence, Perseverance Phase 3, Covent Garden and Farm Phase 2 in Region 4, and Amelia's Ward Phase 3 in Region 10.
Upgrading of roadworks and other infrastructure development works were completed in a number of areas, and we have things to report on.
Yes, yes.
So I can't spend too much time on what is said over the other side. Parfait Harmony, Westminster and Tushen in Region 3, Perseverance, Phase 2, Horstelling, Section EE, Nonpareil in Region 4, Block D, Bath, Region 5,
right.
Number 76, Village and Ordinance, Fort Lands in Region 6, Amelia's Ward, Phase 1B and 2 in Region 10. This component of the program experienced this level of success because the procurement stage was completed very early.
The government continued forward with its efforts to provide adequate, affordable housing for Guyanese by focusing on building complete housing units. During the period under review, 202 units were completed and 52 are in progress and are projected to be completed by mid-December this year.
149 units were completed in Perseverance 4, Region 4. Of that, 76 two-bedroom duplexes, 42 two-bedroom elevated units, right. Two-bedroom flat units, three-bedroom flat units, that's at Perseverance. 17 units were completed at Experiment, Region 5.
Yes.
10 two-bedrooms in Andaniman, Region 3. And I must say that this is just a testing ground in Region 3 and 5, yes. Because they were never accustomed to being provided with housing units.
Never before. 500.
20 units of the 60 are under construction at Amelia's Ward, Region 10.
A total of 154 housing units were allocated to families in 2018. While the housing department had hoped to facilitate the distribution of 1,000 house lots during the year, only 742 were allocated. The allocations were made in regions 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 10. Government also moved to address the issues of squatter settlements in 2018. To this end, 211 squatters were regularized, while 209 persons received titles to their lands. The government's plan for an all-inclusive Guyana will be realized through the implementation and execution of its policies in 2019, the good life, as promised by the coalition government, continues.
This has been InfoHub In-Depth. Thanks for joining us. Goodbye.